This is a short demonstration on how to contribute to the discussion group this week. So in order to get to our discussion group page, you can click on the link either in the horizontal tab or on the vertical tab. They both will take you to the same place. So let's go to the discussion group. And at this point, your page should load up similar to this. If for some reason your page does not load up and it says you don't have permission to view this, then email me and I'll see if I can fix what's going on. Now on your advanced discussion group page, the first thing you see is the welcome message. This will never change. And now you see the topic. So the first week, this is our topic. So you click on the topic and you go to another page. So this is the topic question, and you read the question, and then you're going to post a reply. So you can click in one of two places to reply. I think probably the easiest is clicking up here where the reply is, and you click on that, and it will automatically open up in a reply window. Let's see what a reply window looks like. This is confusing because a reply window looks almost exactly like the posting. You have the actual post underneath it, and up here is where you're going to post your reply. Now, if you choose, you can delete the original message because then it won't show up on your reply. And to save space, you might choose to do that. So the way you delete it is you just take your left cursor and you drag it through all the text, and then you just hit delete on your keyboard. And that gets rid of all that original text. Now you might have to still come up and read the question. That's one of the reasons why that post stays there, so it can remind you what the question is. But I do want you to know that you can delete it when you're done with it. You don't have to, but you can. Okay, and then you can post your reply. Now one thing you might consider is that some of us have aging eyes and normal font is pretty darn small. So if you click on normal and then click on large, your font will be a little bit larger. And then you just type in your response. So my memory relies more on the eMemory devices. If something is underlined, it means that you've misspelled it. In order to find the correct spelling, you could put your cursor on the underlined thing and you can right click. And from there, it will give you some suggestions. Now in this case, I meant to say eMemory, so I can add it to the dictionary. So now whenever I type eMemory, it will not give me the red slide. Hopefully your answer will be a little bit more in depth than this, but let's say this is your answer and you're happy with this. Then you can click post. Before we leave here, there's all sorts of other formatting things you can do. If you would like a tutorial on that, let me know and I'll tell you about what some of these things mean. In fact, probably as time goes on, we'll probably bring them up. But for now, all you need to know is how to read the topic, to post on it, and then when you're done, you hit post. And now it's posting the reply, and now your reply has been posted. So if you were to go back to your website, you will see now that there is a post, and there should be not only the original topic, but now we've got responses. Now, one more thing. We're all going to have different responses. When we go to do our reply, you have two you can reply to. You can reply to the topic, which is what I want you all to do. I want you all to click on the topic to post your reply. But at the same time, maybe what somebody wrote is something that's interesting to you, so you can reply to that person as well. So you have options. But for this assignment, the first thing I want you to do is reply to the topic. So everyone will hit post reply up here. But then after you get done, I encourage you to go back and read what other people have said. And if you like what they said, you can post a reply there. This reply will be on the reply that we had, my memory relies more on eMemory devices, and I might say me too, okay? And again, if you want to make the font bigger and you forgot, you can left click and drag and click large, and then it will make it bigger. Okay, and then you post again. So now on our website, we have the topic, we have a reply to the topic, And then we have a reply to the reply. You can see they get a little bit confusing now and then, but nevertheless, the important thing that we do here is we start our conversation. So try this week. And again, if you have any difficulty posting, let me know, because this is a new discussion board and we might have to do some changes on it. But I'm hoping that it's going to work for everyone. I think I have our group set up so that you won't receive emails every time we do a post. So you're going to have to go to the website and see what has been written, and then you can reply from there. All right, good luck. Email me if you have any questions.